On Tuesday, Parliament approved 1.8 billion shilling budget to facilitate the send-off of the fallen Speaker, Jacob Olanya. However, legislators from Acholi, Lango and West Nile walked out of the National Organizing Committee meeting in disappointment after learning that the budget had been cut from 1.8 billion down to 1.2 billion shillings. They claim the new figure undermines the state burial standards, which should ensure a befitting farewell.
Budget was coming in Parliament, it was reduced to 1.8 billion. Again, surprisingly today, when we went for the meeting, the budget, which is approved by Parliament at 1.8 billion, has been reduced to 1.2 billion. So when we went further to look at what are the components of 1.2 billion that they're talking about, we realize the money is allocated for non-priority areas, and actually it gives you an impression that there is no seriousness in giving state burial to the fallen hero.
This is not about how much money. Ours is about according our brother a decent send-off, the state burial which is talked about. But what we see right now does not give the picture of that state burial being talked about.
Addressing press at Parliament today, led by the chairperson, Acholi Parliamentary Group, Anthony Akol, they raised gaps in the budget, wondering why non-priority areas like transportation of VVIPs, accreditation for the Kololo event, and security are taking the lion's share.
In Kololo, we have budgeted, the budget is talking of 5,000-seater tent for 2 days in Kololo. And yet we very well know that the NOC is planning for only 2,000 guests.
And 1 day.
And for only 1 day. The prayers will happen for only 1 day. So, and that is going to 60 million. Those are areas that we are really not happy with.
7 million is allocated for accreditation of people who are going to go there. Now, which one is a priority? Is it a burial ground to be prepared, to be ready? When people in Muyenga, the feeding itself is a problem. The family members are suffering with some people who cannot even eat.
MPs expressed concerns over lack of enough food to feed mourners at both Muyenga Home and Inomoro District.
Reached Lalogi, at least the father of the late was feeding the people, actually slaughtering his own cows. So this need to be taken into consideration. Thank you. We need to be together to have the best send-off for our Right Honourable Speaker who left.
Expected this to come at this moment. The issue of adjustment of the budget is hurting us so much. Even the adjusted budget that we are talking about now, if we are to look critically, whether really the will and the commitment to put things in reality, in action, on the ground, you realize that there is a lot that is missing.
With only 4 days left to the burial, Northern Uganda MPs claim no money has been released for the local organizing committee in Omoro to prepare the burial grounds to befitting standards.
Going on, the burial ground, the grading of the area as it was agreed, what should be done, there is no fuel available. Even the polar dancers who came all the way from Agago, they're in Kampala here, no money has been released to take care of them. Right now, as I talk, they are sharing rooms, some of them, three people in one room, six of them in one room, because there are no available resources.
Jacob Olanya had succeeded in uniting the people of Northern Region. And therefore, the focus of NOC has remained in Kampala. The money is not released. But the people, Jacob united in the Northern Region, are gathering to celebrate his life, but there is no preparation. I have clearly noted that some people want to turn this funeral into an enterprise for making money, because priorities are being given to non-priority areas.
They've given governments up to tomorrow, Monday, midday, to address the funding gaps in Olanya's burial, or else they start their own fundraising campaign for the event.
In the diaspora, in Uganda, on the ground, has been actually telling us, If government is not releasing money, just tell us we are ready to contribute. And not only Acholi people, the West Nile, the Lango sub-region, and the rest of Ugandans.
Babalanda has responded via Twitter, saying she has heard the concerns of the Acholi MPs and advised them to follow up with the clerk because Parliament is in charge of their service providers. This report was compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.